Welcome back to Microbial Concepts. So today's topic is about some methods or techniques for fungal subculture. Okay, so you must be guessing like what I am going to discuss in this video. So there are some basic techniques that may help out to you for having a very good fungal subculture plate. Okay, so it depends on your skills, how good you are in subculturing. Okay, so bacterial subculturing and fungal subculturing is difficult because in fungi you are dealing with lots of spores, fungal spores, and if you are not careful while lifting up spores and then putting it on your media, and if you say due to air current or due to a little jerk, what happens? Those spores get scattered into your plate and you end up getting lots of colonies on your plate. Okay, so that is the main problem that many of students they are facing. And if you want a good image to be published in say a research article or a research paper, or say in even in your thesis, so that image should be proper. It should be of a single colony, okay, a fungal plate or we can say a media plate which has a very beautiful fully grown single fungal colony. Okay, so that gives a very good idea about how your culture actually looks and how big the colony can grow. Okay, so I think these are some basic things or basic methods which may help you out. Okay, so before starting to this video, reminder for all those who are new to my channel and they don't know that what are the other videos on fungi that are present on my channel. So I had listed these four here. There are I guess two to three more videos on fungi. So about slide culture technique, about lactophenol, about techniques. In techniques video, I had discussed everything, all the techniques which a student can use to identify a particular fungal culture. Okay, then what is the difference between actinomycetes and fungi? So these are all different videos which are related to fungi, and you can get these videos on my channel. And there are some Viva questions listed out in all these videos. Okay, so my videos will also help you out for your Viva questions or your Viva exam. Okay, so get your basics clear. If you are dealing with fungi, I will just remind you to be patient and be what I can say, soft skill. Okay, you should have patience while you are dealing with fungi, and your hand should be soft and gentle while you are dealing with fungal cultures. Okay, and one more thing, if you don't know about the fungal culture, it is unknown culture, then please be cautious because many fungal strains, they are pathogenic. Okay, so let's start. So the first technique that you can use is a wire loop or a forceps. Okay, so you can directly inoculate some part from the master colony towards the to your second or your subculturing plate. Okay, from your master plate you can pick up the fungal fragments or a little bit of a little amount of fungal spores, and you can directly inoculate into your subculturing media plate, or else you can use wire loop and you can directly inoculate from master plate to your subculturing plate. This is the first technique. But the problem comes here is, if as I said before, that if you are not gentle and due to say little jerk or due to the air current, it may happen that your spores, they land up beforehand. Okay, means before reaching to your center where you want to, where you actually want to inoculate, your spores land up or they get scattered in your media plate and you get something like this. So this is not a very good picture that you should use if you want to publish your work. Okay, so what you can do, Another method is using loop full of spore suspension. Okay, make a spore suspension and use a loop full of that spore suspension and you inoculate. So in case of spore suspension, what will happen? You can eliminate the problem of spores landing on your media plate or scattering on your media plate. Okay, so something like this you can get. So this is a very beautiful picture of Aspergillus. Actually, this is a fungal plate which belongs to genus Aspergillus. Okay, so see how beautiful the plate looks, and this is something that you can now add up to your research paper, research article, or even to your thesis. Okay, then third is using a cork borer, or even some institutes you will find they call it as plunger as well. Okay, so this is a manual technique again. So you can use this particular small equipment. You can sterilize that or just flame incinerate that using alcohol, and you can use to get some small disc from the fungal mycelia. Okay, so you just put this cork borer into your media. It cuts out, it helps you to cut out a disc from media plate. Okay, you lift that particular disc and you inoculate to your subculturing plate or to your another plate. Okay, so this is taken from internet. These images are taken from internet and copyrights are reserved to those particular websites. So this is what I was talking about. So see, here are some small fungal colonies. Okay, I had shown some three types. One is yellow color, one is green color, and one is black color. So what you can do, when the fungal colony is small in size, you can directly use a cork borer to get entire colony being transferred. Okay, so you can cut out all these three colonies, which are actually small in size, they are not fully grown, and you can transfer those to your another plate. Okay, this is how you can subculture. But the precaution here is to be taken that when you get, or when you bore into your media plate, you get that disc, it is actually, the growth is actually upside. By using a toothpick or your stab needle wire loop, you need to invert that. Okay, that is very, very important. And after inverting, you can inoculate that into this your center of your plate, and you can incubate. So that was regarding small colonies. What if you have a fully grown fungal culture and you need to subculture from that? So from periphery or from the margin of your colony, you can use the plunger, you can use the cork borer to get some similar disc, and you need to inoculate that further. Same method, just the difference is here the colony is fully grown, and in previous slide the colonies were very small. Okay, so this was our third technique. So this is a plate for Fusarium I guess Solani. I worked with this culture, and this was the method which I used. Okay, so I wanted to subculture Fusarium, and I wanted to store that, okay, for further work. So what I did, I subcultured the Fusarium culture by adding three disc to single plate. Okay, it depends on you how much disc you want to inoculate per plate. You can inoculate a single disc at center or three at periphery. Okay, so it also helps you to see how the colony is growing, okay, whether there is contamination or not. You should see all these three colonies should have same characteristics. Okay, so you can easily subculture and maintain your cultures by this method. In my other slides, I have written that inoculation should be done as your disc is inverted. Okay, so why for inoculation one should invert the disc? And that is the proper way. Why I'm keep saying that? The growth should touch the media. The reason is if you keep your disk like this, as shown here, that will be problematic because the fungal colony here is in contact with just this particular agar block. Okay, so it will grow only till the point where it is able to have, or it is able to get nutrients from this particular agar block. Once the nutrients are lost, the colony of fungal culture will not grow further. Okay, and you will get just fungal growth up to this particular area. Okay, so to avoid that, we need to invert the disc and the growth should touch media so that it will have access to the new media surface, right? So that is the reason why you need to invert your disc. So don't forget, if you are using this particular technique, the one that is cork borer, and the other one which I will be discussing is the bent loop block cutting technique. For that also you need to invert your block and inoculate. Okay, now if you don't have a cork borer, what will you do? So you can use a bent type of inoculating needle. Okay, so the inoculating needle is bent at the tip, and that tip you can use to cut out the media. Okay, so same, you need to flame incinerate or flame sterilize your wire loop. Okay, that way only you will flame sterilize your bent needle, and when it is hot enough, you need to cut out the colony. Now the care should be taken that your colony should not get in contact with your hot needle, otherwise the fungal culture may die. So from the periphery, you need to, not periphery, I will say, keeping the culture or keeping the colony in center, you mark your area and you cut out the agar block. Okay, so as I have shown here, so after getting your agar block cut, by using that same bent needle, you can easily pluck it out. Okay, as the needle is having a bent or it has an angle, so you can easily use that particular angle to get your agar block picked. And same agar block you have to inoculate for subculturing, use for inoculation for subculturing. Again, the care should be taken that the growth side should touch the media plate. Okay, if you keep agar block as it is, the growth facing upward, now the colony will not grow further. Why? Because the nutrient media, which is new, that is way apart from your fungal colony, and the colony will just grow till the point where it has the nutrient access from that particular block only. Okay, so it is very important that you invert your block and then inoculate so that the fungal culture grows properly into your new media plate, right? So after doing that, you incubate further for getting a good growth. All right, so these were some basic techniques which I know and I am sharing with you all, but there may be some other techniques that are being used. Okay, so if you know something other than this, please comment that in comment box so that others can get a help from that. And thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel, and do recommend my channel to your friends, and also tell them to subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook by the same handle, Microbial Concepts. Okay, so till then, bye bye, and thank you for watching. Keep supporting.